Today we continue to discuss equation with Hausch and Strong random operators, and we finished last lecture with the announcement of the following example. Let us consider linear stochastic differential equation. Here we have a t x t dt plus b t x t d w t with the initial condition x 0, which is simply measure with respect to sigma field generated by the linear process on the interval 0, 1. We discussed that in this case, equation must be created as an equation with anticipating stochastic integral, namely there, because of this anticipating initial condition. And we have seen already that it can be viewed as an equation with Hausch-Tron random operator. Today we will solve this equation and see what is the form of its solution. As we agreed last time, let us begin with the case when A is equal to 0. So in the form which is more convenient for us, we will consider this equation as equation with Hausch-Strong random operator of the following kind. Here is gamma, multiply on the indicator of the interval 0, 1, plus integral from 0 to t b s b s x s d w s. So in this case, our Hausch-Strong random operator in L2 0 1 looks like a of u from t is equal to integral from 0 to t bs us dws. We discussed that fruitful idea to solve such kind of equation, especially in case when we have no non-random part in this operator A, it has zero mean, is to write a Newman series. So we will do this, and let's try to write successful approximations to the solution. So I will, as usual, suppose that x zero t is equal gamma t belongs to 0, 1. Then x1t will be equal gamma plus integral from 0 to t gamma bs dws. Before to write second term of our sequence, let us continue calculations here, because we have here a situation which we discussed last time, namely it is related to the possibility to put out a random constant from the sign of Gaussian Strong random operator, in this case from sign of Skorohod integral, according to the special rule. So it will be equal to gamma plus gamma multiply on the integral from 0 to t bs dws minus integral from 0 to t. And here we will have a stochastic derivative of gamma. You remember that our rule was exactly following. We have to subtract such term, multiply it on bs ds. So we have such a representation for the first term of our approximating sequence. Now let's go further and write second one. X two t will be equal all this. So gamma plus gamma on the integral from 0 to t bs dws minus integral from 0 to t d gamma s bs ds. Then plus we have to substitute this one inside of the stochastic integral again. So let's see what we will have. We'll have the following. Again, the integral from 0 to t, then here we have gamma plus gamma integral from 0 to t1 bs dws minus integral from 0 to t1 d gamma s bs bs ds. Then we have to multiply this on the to b t1 d w t. Now let's calculate this. What will happen? What will happen? There are a lot of summands there, so I will consider such summands that are new for us. For example, here. We have such a new summand, gamma multiply on the integral and integrate it again. Let us consider this summand more precisely. We will have integral from 0 to t, gamma integral from 0 to t1, bs dws b t1 dw t1. So as we discussed, gamma can be subtracted from this integral out of the sine of integral, but with the additional term, it will be equal to gamma multiply on the double integral from 0 to t, from 0 to t1. Here is bs dws bt1 dwt1 minus, unfortunately, I have to erase something. Minus integral from 0 to t. Here is d gamma t1 integral from 0 to t1 ds dws. Here is b. Then now let us use again our rule with the random variable and stochastic integral. And one can put it inside. One can put it inside of the integral and continue calculations. So it will be like the first one, gamma multiply. I will write it in familiar for us notation. This is a simplex. With respect to two coordinates t1 and s, here is b s b t1 dw s dw t1 minus what we have here. We can say that this is equal to integral from 0 to t. Here is integral from 0 to t1 d gamma 1 bs dws bt1 d dt1 and plus here what we will have. We have here the second derivative, so integral from 0 to t, integral from 0 to t1, d, 2 gamma t1 s bs bt1 d ds ds dt1 exactly in the same kind you can write all summands which we get in our representation. I just write one in order to give you the flavor of our calculations. Why? Because please see carefully on this term. Maybe one can imagine that when we consider second terms of approximations, of approximation and other term, you will get the infinite sum of gamma multiplied on such integrals. So let me write already the answer because you see a lot of calculations there and you have to continue such calculations. So let me write you what will happen. First of all, we will have gamma multiplied on the infinite sum of such integrals. This is xt will be equal to gamma multiply on the sum from n equals 0 to infinity integral delta n t b let me write t1 dtn and here is dw t1 dwt. This is the first term. Plus, oh, excuse me, minus, because we have second derivative, the first derivative, so minus. Then we will have terms with gamma, derivative of gamma. And let me just say, because I have a very small board, just say that after calculations, we will have the following. It will be a sum, but now double sum from k1 to k2 equal 0 to infinity. And here we will have the full integral from 0 to t, integral delta k1 t, excuse me, not t, but s. Here is BT1, BTK1, DW, T1, DW, TK1. Multiply on d gamma at the point S, b of S, and then new one delta K2. Here is from S to T. This is a simplex where the variables are ordered from the minimum s up to maximum t. Here is b again, for example, r1, b rk2, dw r1, dw rk2, and then d S. Plus analogous term where we will have double integral containing d gamma S1, S2, and the same integrals over simplexes. But see what happened when we consider such one sum. This sum arise here because we have such sum there, we have the same sum there. We already know the value of this infinite sum. Let me show you it. To have such value, Let us consider the additional equation dyt is equal just bt yt dwt, but with y 0 equal to 1. This is a usual Cauchy problem for Itô stochastic differential equation, and we know that it has a unique solution which is a stochastic exponent. So we know, and it can be easily checked using by using Itô formula, that this is like exponent equal e integral from 0 to t bs dws minus 1/2 integral from 0 to t b square s ds. So this is a usual stochastic exponent, and one can check that it arises in our considerations due to this representation of the infinite sums. We will get a very interesting formula like following. Our solution x will be equal to the sum from n equals 0 to infinity. Here is minus 1 in n power. I multiply it on the integral of the simplex. Here is nth derivative of our random variable gamma. Here is s1 sn. B is 1 b sn. D s 1 d sn. Multiply on the stochastic exponent. this happens because the stochastic exponent has a multiplicative property. And when we calculate it, for example, in this case, on the interval 0, s, and then on the interval s, t, the product is equal exactly the same stochastic exponent up to the time t. So we have such a nice representation for our solution. Finally, we have such formula, but this formula can be simplified even more. And we will face something very familiar to us in this representation. By the way, let me note that if we have simply non-random initial condition gamma, then of course all terms with the stochastic derivatives disappears, they are equal to zero, and we have only one term which is related to gamma multiply on the stochastic exponent, as we have seen already from Itô calculus. Now let's check what is this, because it is something very familiar for us. So, in order to understand,
sorry, I have a question.
Yes.
So, in order to have solutions to these equations, you need gamma to be smooth, like completely smooth.
You see, this is a good question, and exactly now, I am going to transform this formula in such way that we will have no any derivatives of gamma.
Aha, okay.
Yes, this is the first remark. The second remark. Yes, in order to have a convergent Itô Wiener series and to be allowed to have the stochastic integral with gamma, we need something from gamma.
Okay.
Actually, as we have seen already, sufficient condition is existence of the derivatives.
I see.
And so this technical moment, but we will get a good, very good formula, and then we will have a new definition of the solution, where we will omit any restriction on gamma. To do this, let us consider this term, and we will understand what is this. Okay, so let me recall you that this dn gamma is an element of L2 0 1 in n power symmetric. But when we calculate here it over simplex, I can rewrite this integral because of symmetricity of everything. I can rewrite this integral as an integral over such like generalized square. Let's do this. So let us consider one sum and rewrite. We have just integral over simplex delta nt d n gamma t1 tn b t1 b tn d t1 dtn is equal to, since I want to have the integral over the box, not over the simplex, and I have symmetric function under the integral, I just put here one over n factorial, and here I will have such integral from zero. I will put here even one, and here is dn gamma T1 Tn, and here BT1 multiply on the indicator from 0 to T from T1, and then the same BTn multiplied on the indicator of 0 to T Tn DT1 DTN. Yes, because of symmetricity. Now, let me recall you that we even has have such a notion as a stochastic derivative in some direction. And I can continue writing with the following. This is 1 over n factorial, and here is d n gamma applied to this function b multiplied on the indicator of 0 t b multiplied on the indicator of 0 t and so on. B multiplied on the indicator of 0 t. So we have what? We have application of n's derivative to this function. Yeah. Finally, let us came back to our series. Let me write it again. I will use notation BT in order to avoid such a long formula. So this function B multiplied on the indicator of 0. This is BT. So then we have XT is equal to stochastic exponent multiply on the sum from n equals 0 to infinity minus 1 in n power divided over n factorial, and here is dn gamma bt. I think that this is very familiar for us from the course of calculus. Yeah, it is a Taylor series for gamma, which is shifted on the function t. Yeah, so I can continue writing and say that it is equal to stochastic exponent multiply on the shift of gamma. Let me define it precisely. Here is the definition. First of all, let us consider such a transformation. Xi is going to Xi plus BT. Of course, it is right now very formal, because there are no xi. Xi is a generalized random element. But in our case, one can have a very precise definition, because in our case, xi is w with dot, formal derivative of w. And in our case, one can consider such transformation: wt plus the integral. I have put here new variable s plus integral from 0 to s bt s. Only maybe, excuse me, minus everywhere because of this minus 1. Here and here must be minus. So this is a good transformation in C01. Yes, this is a good transformation in C01 in the space of continuous functions. Moreover, this transformation is admissible for Wiener method. Yes. For Wiener measure. Because we discussed it with you that Wiener measure can be shifted on the integral from L2 function. Here is exactly such situation. This transformation is correctly defined. And if we have gamma, which is from F1, then gamma can be represented as a function from W. And this function is unique up to the Wiener measure. And then one can define TT of gamma. It is just phi of W minus this integral with dot BT S DS. So this is a right definition of the shift. And you can check that if gamma is, for example, just finite sum from into Wiener expansion terms. So it is like generalized polynomial from Wiener process. Then this Taylor sum with the stochastic derivatives of gamma is exactly the following. And finally, one can say, finally, one can say that, okay, maybe our solution is xt equal to tt of gamma multiplied by the stochastic component. This is a formula. We just have to move our gamma along to probability space, you see. So the anticipated stochastic differential equation also require some structure on the probability space, and as a solution we also have some motion, not only in the phase space as we usually have habit, but in the probability space too. Of course, Alexander asked a very right question. What is the technical condition? Yeah? What is the what are the technical conditions under which we have a solution? The answer is follows. In order to use the Taylor formula, which I presented to you, we have a very restrictive conditions on gamma, that gamma has infinitely many stochastic derivatives, and they are they satisfy some estimations, yeah, like you can require that the L2 norm is bounded uniformly. But when we have such a formula, since this formula is very nice, it is good to have some definition of the solution such that we can apply it there without any restriction or under the small amount of restrictions. So let me introduce to you the definition of the new definition of the solution to anticipate and stochastic differential equation. I will use term weak solution, but this is not weak solution in a sense of Itô stochastic differential equation when we have to enlarge probability space to have a solution which is not adapted to the filtration of the initial Wiener process. Here, term weak is more or less related to application of some transformation. You will see. So, so to introduce to you this definition, I will just recall you the notion of Fourier Wiener transform. What will let us consider again stochastic exponent related to some vector h. It is like psi h minus 1/2 the norm of h squared. This is abstract stochastic exponent, and we already considered it. Because it has a very good Itô Wiener expansion. It is equal to the sum from n equals 0 to infinity. And here we have just 1 over n factorial. H tensor in n power and line by xi, xi, xi. We have seen such representation for this exponent, and it is useful because it helped us to recover Itovinner expansions of arbitrary random variables and elements. For example, if I have alpha, which has Itovinner expansion like this, a n xi xi xi, then if I calculate if I calculate expectation of alpha multiplier our stochastic exponent h, then due to the properties of Itovinner expansion, we will have such series sum from n equals 0 to 50 a n h h h. You see that this expectation is analytic function with respect to h. Please check that series converge. It follows from definition and properties of Itovinner expansion, but you will check that it converges as a Taylor series for this function. So one can find these kernels simply as a derivatives of this function with respect to h at the point zero. From this point of view, one can say that here we have some transformation of initial alpha, which is which maybe is useful for us in order to calculate something related to this random variable. And we will say that Fourier winner transform of alpha is new function tau alpha from h, which is equal by definition expectation of alpha multiplying the stochastic. That's the definition of the Fourier-Winner transform. And why it is called Winner transform? Maybe it is understandable because it is closely related to Itovinner expansion, and Winner was the first who introduced multiple integrals for Winner process. But why it is called Fourier transform? It occurs that this transformation has very nice properties with respect to extended stochastic integral, and in more general form, with respect to action of Gaussian strong random operators on the random elements. Let's see what happened. Let us consider the Skorohod integral, integral from 0 to 1, for example, x t dwt. Suppose that x is the domain of this integral, and try to find what is this. So let us try to find Fourier-Winner transform of this integral. Yeah. Let me recall you how it works. In the definition, so when we build this Skorohod integral, we proceed as follows: x t was expanded in yet in interim exercise. Here is let me write it as follows: the integral from 0 to 1 b this kernel maybe smaller b t t1 tn dw t1 dw tn. Yes. Then this integral from 0 to 1 xt dwt is expressed as sum from n equals 0 to infinity. Here is integral, but now let me emphasize n, n plus 1, 0 to 1, lambda b, this is just symmetrization. And here is t1, tn plus 1, dw t1, dw tn plus 1. Okay, so you remember this definition. We discussed it several times in the last semester, and in this semester we also discussed this idea of symmetrization when considered action of Gaussian-Strong random operator on the random elements. So we have two random objects. Let's apply Fourier-Wiener transform to both these objects. So first of all, let me write it for x. You see that tau xt h is equal to what we have to do. Very simple. You remember that we just substitute xi, which is a formal derivative of w, by h. So I am doing the same here. This is a sum from n equals 0 to infinity. Integral n time 0 1 bt bt t1 tn h t1 h tn dt1 dtn. Yes. The same happened here. Let me write it. The tau of the integral from 0 to 1 xt dwt h is equal to the following sum. Sum from n equals 0 to infinity. And then what we have to write this one. Unfortunately, I have to erase, but you have the formula in your notes. It is equal to, integral here is 0, 1. N plus 1 time, here is lambda b t1 tn plus 1 h t1 h tn plus 1 dt1 dtn plus 1. Now it is a crucial moment. You see, what I am integrating here? I am integrating symmetrization of B, but I multiply this symmetrization on symmetric function. Yes, because this product is symmetric under permutations of all coordinates t1 and so on, tn plus 1. Yes, since then I can forget this symmetrization. Yeah. Nothing will change. Then comparing this and this, I can continue and say that this is simply equal to integral from 0 to 1 tau x t from h multiply on h of t dt. You see, such a very nice formula. We consider Fourier-Wiener transform of extended or Skorohod stochastic integral, and it occurs that Fourier-Wiener transform of this Skorohod integral is equal to integral of Fourier-Wiener transform initial random function multiply on h dt. This is exactly property which we have for usual Fourier transform in the course of mathematical physics. When we begin to study linear partial differential equation, we just say Fourier transform is very useful because it turns differentiation into multiplication on the argument. You have here exactly the same. This integral, new one for us, complicated and so on, just turns into the multiplication on the argument of Fourier-Wiener transform and integration. Yeah. Since then, let's go further. Let's try to apply this this transformation now to our stochastic anticipating equation. So let us consider again xt equal gamma plus integral from 0 to t dt, or excuse me, bs xs dws. Then tau xt of h is equal to tau gamma of h plus integral from 0 to t ds tau xs from h hs ds. And here we have a very simple equation with respect to this function. Yes, it is a function of t. It is unknown, but this is a linear integral equation, and we can easily check that it has a unique solution of the kind tau xt of h is equal to tau gamma of h multiply on the exponent, and here we have integral from 0 to t bs hs ds. That's all. So we have a nice representation for Fourier-Wiener transform of the solution. What is remaining to do? Two things. First of all, recognize here the solution which we already get with the shift and multiplication on stochastic exponent. And second one, to produce a definition of the solution to our initial stochastic anticipating equation in the weak sense, namely in the sense of Fourier-Wiener transform. We will do this next time. For today, that's all. Thank you for your attention, and maybe somebody have questions or comments.
Yes, can you invert the Fourier-Wiener transform?
Yes. We at least know that the correspondence is one-to-one. Because let me recall you that We have a following. We have the tau, for example, gamma h is equal to sum from n equals 0 to infinity a n h h h. So at least we know that if we have to even transform, we can recover gamma. Of course, the technical question, can we have a good formula like in case of Fourier transform? No, we haven't. And the explanation is following. You see that kernel of Fourier transform is just it is related to the shift of initial Gaussian measure, but this is admissible shift. In order to use something like kernels again, we have to invent something like Lebesgue measure on infinitely dimensional space. But there are no such measures. So there are no such good kernel for inverse transform.
Okay, but at least this gives us existence. Well, not a good formula, but then existence of a solution, so to say.
Yes, we can work with Fourier inverse transform, get this one and check everything. Yeah.
Okay,
so next time we'll try to find the shift of gamma, to find the stochastic exponent, so we will exactly work with the inverse in brackets Fourier transform. Okay, thank you, bye.